Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, I am going to talk about breastfeeding hacks, tips, essentials and all of that. I am a mom to a 7 month old baby girl and I have been exclusively breastfeeding her. I have not given her formula. I mean, she was a little bit underweight when she was born. She was 2 kgs. So the doctor had recommended to give her formula. So I did that for just a week and then I stopped giving her formula altogether. So I have been just breastfeeding her and these are the tips, hacks, essentials and all of the things that I wish I knew before I breastfed.
So without too much blabbering, let's get into the video.
First tip I have for you guys is use a manual breast pump like this one, not the regular manual pump that you have to pump like this. Use this one while you breastfeed your baby. From one side, there is usually always leaks on the other side, so the milk gets wasted. So what you can do is just, you know, pop this on your other breast like this, create a vacuum, and then this will hold itself in place, so whatever milk leaks, this pump will hold, and then you can store it in the refrigerator and give it to your baby. Breast milk is liquid gold, guys. You just cannot afford to waste even 1 ml of it, so this comes in very, very handy for that. And also, if you have really fuller breasts and you just want to extract a little bit of milk out, this would be really helpful. Again, just hook this onto your breast and then pump it a few times, and the extra milk will be extracted in this pump, and then your nipples will be softened and then you can feed the baby. So I think this is a very, very amazing product for me. Like, it has helped me a lot. And also very easy to clean. It does not have too many parts, just one single pump, easy. Just you just have to pour in water and soap and then clean it. Very easy, hassle free. I just love this. So the second thing I have for you guys is how to use how to prevent leaks without wearing a bra. So during breastfeeding, sometimes it can be really, really painful, especially when you have fuller breasts, and when you are at home, you really don't feel like wearing a bra all day, but you do not you want to save yourself from those embarrassing leaks. What you can do is take a breast pad and then tape it with the tape that you get in the medical stores. Just tape it, just put a tape on the back side and then just tape it onto your breast. Like, if this is your breast, just tape it directly on your breast, and it will hold all the leaks inside and you do not have to wear a bra. So that's a win-win situation. At least for me, it was. This saved me a lot of embarrassing. So the third product I have for you guys is this calendula cream. This is a homeopathic cream, and for anyone suffering from sore, cracked nipples, this cream is a lifesaver. I was suffering from painful nipples for around 15 to 20 days while I was traveling. So when I came back home, I consulted a lactation specialist and she recommended this cream to me, and I used this just for one night, and my nipples were healed overnight. I could feed Inaya without any pain the very next day. So that is how amazing this cream is. The fourth tip I have for you guys is using a hair tie on the side that you have breastfed. So if you have breastfed your baby from the right side, use a hair tie on the right hand, and then the next time you have to feed the baby from the left side. I know there are a lot of apps and all of that, but we as moms already have so much going on in our minds. We do not act, at least I do not like going opening an app and then input all the data and all of that. That's too much work for me. So this is what comes in handy for me. This is very easy for me and it has worked wonders. So that's what I recommend for you guys. Fifth tip I have for you guys is invest in a nursing pillow. A nursing pillow is something that looks like this. So you just have to attach this around your waist, and then the baby will be you know, laying here, and then it's easier for you to breastfeed. Since Inaya was really tiny, she was just 2 kgs, it was difficult for me to hold her and breastfeed. I would always feel like, what if I hurt her or something? So this was really, really helpful for me. I think this will not be useful for people who have babies that are, you know, 6 months and above. You can only use this for really small babies around 3, like from 0 to 4, 5 months. I think 5 months is the maximum. After that, you cannot use this because your baby becomes really big and she won't fit. Another tip I have for you guys is use a lactation supplement. We as mothers always, always, you know, suffer from low milk supply, or sometimes the quality of the milk is not up to the mark because we do not eat a lot of nutritional stuff. I mean, we have to try and eat good food, but along with that, lactation supplement is a must. When your baby grows, like after 6 to 7 months, they feed a lot, their demand increases, and your supply starts to reduce. So the lactation supplement that I have been using is this Shatavari Gulam. You can get this at any Ayurvedic store. This is the number one product that I recommend for breastfeeding. This is really, really good. But if you cannot get your hands on this one, you can use the lactonic granules. This one has also helped me a lot with breastfeeding, but not as much as this one. This one shows results in one night. Like, so another hack I have for you guys is drink a glass of water just after you breastfeed. So all of you guys who are breastfeeding know that we need to drink at least 3 liters of water a day, and it's difficult with all everything that's going on around the house and all the work and everything. It's very, very difficult for us to keep track of how much water we're drinking. So what I do is every time I feed Inaya, I just go to the kitchen and have a glass of water. That's the time I have kept for drinking water. Sometimes what I do is I carry a glass of water along with me, I breastfeed her, and then drink it immediately once I've done breastfeeding. Breastfeeding also causes a lot of dehydration, so drinking water is very, very essential. So another tip I have for you guys is feed from one side until it's fully drained. I have heard a lot of people here and there who tell me that I have to feed the baby from both the sides at one time, but that is not true. When I've spoken to my lactation consultant, she also recommended the same thing. I have to feed the baby from one side until she drains the milk completely, because with breast milk there is foremilk and hind milk. So foremilk is basically the more watery liquid that comes at the start of the breastfeed, and then there's hind milk that is a more full fat milk that has a lot of fat content in it. So your baby really needs that. So if you feed her for 5 minutes from one side and switch to the other breast for another 5 minutes, she will only get the foremilk and not get the full fat milk that is very, very essential for weight gain of the baby and for its natural development. Another tip I have for you guys is invest in a manual breast pump instead of an electric pump. In an electric pump, sometimes they cause bruises and cracks in your nipples, and it can be painful. Also, electric pumps are very, very expensive. I would recommend using just a manual breast pump like this one. This is from Pigeon. It retails for around 1000 rupees something, and it comes with a plastic bottle, but I have attached a glass bottle along with this because that's better, and this is very affordable and does the job really well. So the last tip I have for you guys is breastfeed if you have a clogged duct. We as moms suffer a lot of clogged ducts during the whole breastfeeding journey, and it can be really, really painful. Sometimes it lasts for 2-3 days. So earlier what I used to do is I used to apply hot compress and pump, but when I did my research online, I found out that breastfeeding is the most effective way to clear a clogged duct. So once I started breastfeeding after I got a clogged duct, I just had to feed her once or twice and my duct would be clear. Also, for a painful, really painful clogged duct, never apply a hot compress. Apply a cold compress to relieve the pain. What you can do is just buy a cabbage and refrigerate it. So whenever you have a clogged duct, just remove one leaf and place it on your breast, and that will soothe the area and relieve the pain that you get from the clogged up. So that is it for the video, guys. These were my hacks, tips, and these are the things that I use on a daily basis and has been proven to be really helpful and really helped my breastfeeding journey. So all the moms who are about to breastfeed or are breastfeeding, I hope this these tips are really helpful. If you guys find these tips helpful, let me know in the comment section below, and also give this video a big thumbs up if you like my tips, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, guys, for watching.